The most effective way to attract an expert technical writer for your organization is to craft a great job description that is detailed and comprehensive. Hi, my name is Josh Fechter. I'm one of the founders of Technical Writer HQ, and I have over 10 years of technical writing experience. In this video, I'll break down the various prerequisites included in the technical writer's job description. I'll also be sharing an ideal template for a technical writer's job description. That way, if you're hiring, you'll have a template that you can use, and whether that be as inspiration or if you want to copy some of it. And if you're looking for a job, you'll better have an understanding of how to frame your resume and cover letter. And before we dive in, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can get direct notifications whenever we post new insightful technical writing videos like this one. That way you'll always get your fair share of high quality instructional content from real technical writing experts. Technical writers, often called technical communicators, are responsible for writing, editing, and rephrasing various technical concepts that are important in many different industries, whether that be software or even aerospace, and putting that into easy to understand technical documents. These technical documents often include software or product policies, instructional manuals, training guides, reports, journal articles, user guides, and much more. A technical writer's job is relatively flexible in an organization. In larger organizations, they are typically assigned into project work groups with other technical writers and technical employees, while in the case of smaller organizations, they sometimes just work alone. In some organizations, they are able to work remotely, removing location and time constraints for qualified job seekers, which is great for job flexibility and often for personal life. It's also worth mentioning, since technological advancements are taking over almost every industry, the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics found that the demand for technical writers between the years 2019 and 2029 is increasing at a rate faster than the average for all occupations, which is very great if your aspirations become a technical writer or stay within that role. Since technical writer is a broad term for writers that create industry-specific technical content, their exact duties and responsibilities vary from organization to organization. However, their general duties and responsibilities are similar across most organizations. Therefore, we'll be talking about some typical duties and responsibilities of a technical writer that you can make specific according to your industry specific needs. Some of the common responsibilities of technical writers are to work with product managers, product marketers, and engineers to produce and maintain world-class documentation. This includes user guides, integration guides, if it's a software company, maybe API developer guides, in-platform documentation, tooltips, onboarding instructions, and a lot more. They also build and maintain custom arrays that go beyond traditional documentation, such as online video, demos, guided tours, and other educational assets. One of the most overlooked parts of technical writing is that the writing part is often the easiest. Technical writers must learn complex concepts. Only then can they communicate the information in a way that is engaging and understood by users. Technical writers are also responsible to gather customer feedback on documentation to improve usability, and they act as an editor to ensure consistency in documentation. The best ones understand how to monitor metrics on the usage of documentation, as well as direct customer feedback to prioritize future documentation investments. This ensures that their documentation actually makes a difference. The first and foremost responsibility of a technical writer is subject matter research. Research is a cornerstone of any writer's process, especially when creating content backed with valid ideas and facts. This is even more necessary for technical writing, since some forms of technical documentation, when crafted correctly, can help companies avoid legal trouble. Similarly, effective instructional manuals and guides, especially for complicated and major machinery, can help avoid operational mishaps and accidents. You don't want to be giving out instructions that are wrong to people operating heavy machinery, for example. Technical writers go above and beyond just fundamental research when looking for facts and insight on the subject. They try to gather as much information as possible with the opportunity costs they are given and the deadline that they have to deliver the documentation. And they do this about a subject and then shift through all that information to single out the details that are most important. This is done with information needs of the audience in mind, and to make sure that they can properly communicate to the audience what's written in order to achieve whatever that desired objective is. Here's an example. You need to describe a new feature of your software company that it is developing. It sounds pretty straightforward. You need to learn what it's called and what it does and how to use it. And off you go, writing a help topic on the subject matter. However, it's not that simple. Here's a bigger list of questions you might want to try and figure out before writing anything. What is the feature name? Is this new feature development of an older feature? What does it do? How to use it? What topics cross-reference this feature? Where the info about it should be added if it's a completely new feature? Where should be placed within the table of contents? Are there any notes, warnings to be added to the feature description? How should you represent it? Should you use screenshot, GIFs, diagrams, a video? Now, that looks like a more or less proper list of questions you need to answer in this scenario before attempting to create a new help topic. So it is not as easy as it seems. In order to provide the right documentation for a user, you really have to empathize with what type of documentation that they need. Then we have the responsibility of organizing facts. Writing on the technical side already involves being very direct with the information the writer is giving out. This requires strong and timely facts that will carry the weight of the content. Depending on the type of technical writer and the tasks they're working on, they'll dedicate a portion of their allotted writing time to organizing all the facts in order of importance to the text. Then they'll build the rest of the content around it. For example, a writer working on a white paper will collect facts about certain events when they're describing the problem. Then they'll organize those facts in a way that best supports the solution. Organizing facts in a specific manner helps writers fine-tune their writing process and dedicate more time to effective research. Moving on here, we have the responsibility to create and deliver content. The writers take the set of content guidelines of their company and align their accumulated content and research with crafting content that will assist their audience, and maybe that be technical staff or customers, as per the objective and the ultimate function that they're trying to get them to take. This specific responsibility is where writing styles and formats differ the most, since dozens of types of content fall under a technical writing umbrella. Some writers may perform an internet search and create content similar to what they find while modifying it slightly to suit project needs. Others may look through academic texts and manuals and conduct numerous user interviews and also interview people that they work with, whether that be product managers and engineers, in order to simply format the knowledge they have gained. Regardless of how their content development process goes, the writers have to generate content and then deliver it through existing channels to the pre-decided audience. Some writers may also be responsible for content distribution and promotion. This is usually the case with small to medium-sized enterprises with limited technical writing resources. Last on our list of primary roles and responsibilities is developing content guidelines. Technical writers who have gained some experience in the field and their host companies are often asked to provide job training to new writers. This training involves creating content based on guidelines that the senior writers develop according to ongoing content needs, policies, and procedures. The guidelines themselves are an essential part of a senior technical writer's job at their company. Depending on the hierarchy, they may also lead the company's effort to create better and more efficient guidelines for future technical content efforts. Additionally, the content guidelines for any business need to be updated with changing business goals and requirements. And this may be the case when there's new release in products, features, or a company gets acquired, whatever that may be. Senior technical content strategists are the point people when developing new guidelines to reflect new business goals better. When a company releases new products, features, and more, often this technical documentation needs updating. So technical writers must be organized to understand what documents need updating and where. And one new feature that gets released may require 40 different pieces of technical documentation to get updated. And if you don't know which pieces those are, you're going to have some problems. So you have to be very, very well organized, and often that comes with using things like a knowledge base. Now that we have looked at a technical writer's typical roles and responsibilities, let's move to the qualifications and experience that an ideal candidate is expected to meet. The first example we'll take a look at is for a role in an online tech company. Here are some of the things you'd see in a job description. 3+ years of technical writing experience. Knowledge-based documentation. If you don't know what a knowledge-based documentation is, make sure to go ahead and Google it. There's a lot of good information out there. And they should also have strong written and verbal communication and experience working with content in multiple mediums. Experience working cross-departmentally to communicate the nuts and bolts of a product. Strong experience owning end-to-end documentation creation process, so all the way from creation to publishing. and excellent attention to detail and the ability to prioritize and work on multiple projects in a fast-paced environment and a changing environment as well. And they should also have experience working with the following tools. So you have things like Confluence, Jira, Git, exposure to different types of documentation publishing software such as Madcap, RoboHelp, and maybe some wiki-based software. And that's just an example. Technical writing job descriptions vary from industry to industry, so it's best we take a look at another example too. Here we have a technical writing position for a SaaS company. Keep in mind that SaaS is one of the fastest growing industries for technical writers and often is one of the best paying industries for technical writers as well. In the job description, we see the applicant should know how to oversee team collaboration with development, QA, and product management, and other groups to plan, research, write, and revise printed and online documentation, including general overviews, tutorials, installation, configuration instructions, training, class materials, and API documentation, and write for a variety of audiences from non-technical end users to programmers, system administrators, and also be able to establish team policies and procedures. And they should also be able to oversee peer editing and production review work and integrate use case and functional data into user documentation and examples. One of the important things to know is that a technical writer job description will often ask about your design skills because you might need to create images like this one. Because technical writing is not just writing, it's communication, both video and design skills are incredibly important to succeeding on the job. So make sure to look at all the tools that can help you with that, like ScreenFlow or Snagit. There's tons of tools out there that can get you better at that specific aspect of technical writing. Here we see an example of what to expect from an okay technical writer. You may not be able to spot the mistake, but I'll give you a hint. It's in the first sentence. A great job description will attract technical writers who don't make mistakes. A good one will leave you with a technical writer that can fool your team, but not the end user. The answer to the mistake is surprisingly the first word. The issue is that the meaning of the word recently changes depending on when the end user reads the content. And because of this is actually a huge mistake, but it's often something you wouldn't notice because a lot of the other parts of this document look good. But for a great technical writer, they'll notice this right away. So it's important to be specific about the who, what, where, when, and why details. Just because you have most of them doesn't mean the end user will empathize with you. So that's why it's important to have such a great job description so you don't have a technical writer who fools you and can make a mistake like that that can really screw things up. One thing that helps technical writers stand out today is the use of certifications. And a certificate acts as an affirmation of the talents and qualities of a candidate and lowers the perceived risk of hiring a candidate. Technical writing certifications from organizations such as Society for Technical Communication or training from other institutions like the one that I own, Technical Writer HQ, reflects the competency and professionalism of the candidate. And there's not a lot of technical degrees that are offered, even though it's such an in-demand position. So these certifications really help you stand out. And furthermore, almost all technical writers are skilled in a diverse set of writing tools and software, which you can specify in the job description. And we'll talk a little bit more about those later in this video. Now that we have discussed the qualifications expected in a technical writer, let us now move to the experience part. Candidates with 2 to 4 years of experience as a technical writer for engineering, IT, management, or other related industries, whether that be consumer electronics, computer systems, design, software publishing, and much more, and mostly technical industries, are preferred among HR staff and other hiring managers. If you don't have technical writing experience, you can still be considered if you have prior experience in design and development and have worked as a research assistant or a specialist in a technical field. Since technical writing is such a multi-dimensional field, flexible candidates with first-hand experience in different fields such as finance, marketing, technology, and strategy, among many others, are again preferred among HR and hiring staff. So having that deep T knowledge in a certain area is going to really help you. So find out what you're interested in, dive in, become a specialist there, and then you can apply for a technical writing job there. Before we head off, here are some of the important tools you may see on a technical writer job description. And a lot of these have tutorials online that are free to check out, and a lot of them have free trials, so you can try them out for free. The tools that we have are FrameMaker, Microsoft Office, SharePoint, Flare, RoboHelp, Acrobat, Visio, Captivate, Camtasia, Snagit, CMS, like WordPress, for example, ScreenFlow, Squibbler, Loom, Document 360, Proto.io, Hemingway, and Grammarly. And that's just a number of them. And there's quite a lot of tools here that you can check out, and it's important to know what tools you need for the job. Otherwise, you'll be throwing darts in the dark. And if you're a hiring manager, you want to be specific with the tools that you say that your candidates need. Even though you might get fewer people applying, you'll get better candidates, which will give you better results. The perfect technical writer job description template requires a lot more than simply listing down the skills and responsibility of the job title. In order to attract the best potential candidates, it's crucial to follow the steps of a well-written job description that we've covered in this video. Make sure that it's tailored to what your company needs, what your industry needs, and how to scale your company properly, and that you set right expectations for the person who is applying for the job. And now that you've learned the fundamentals of a good technical writer job description, feel free to go ahead and comment below if you have any questions. And of course, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to Technical Writer HQ channel on YouTube. And with that said, I'll go ahead and see you in the next video. And I wish you the best luck in your career journey. If you are learning more about how to create a great resume with this video, and if you're looking to hire, then I wish you the best in your hiring journey. And you can also check out the jobs portal on Technical Writer HQ, where if you are a hiring manager, you can post jobs there. If you're looking for a job, you can find tons of technical writer jobs there and people actively hiring. And with that said, again, wish you the best of luck and cheers.